The men of purpose here at Faith City proudly present, is your life shouting, crucify him.
Title of this drama was entitled, Is Your Life Shouting, Crucify Him? Meaning that if you were to take inventory of your life, is your life running perpendicular to the Word of God, or is it running parallel? Meaning, are you doing the things that God has so called you to do? Are you saying the things that God has so called you to say? Are you going the places that God has so called you to go? Or have you just been sitting in the crowd, going along with the crowd? On today, what better day to be freed, to be loosed? So I'm appealing to your heart as you stand on your feet, because I don't know what company we have in this house. Perhaps you are one who, for the last 365 days, God hasn't been high on your priority list. Living a life that Christ could be pleased with haven't been high on your priority list. And today you want to rededicate your life. Well, I think today is a great day. Number one, this is the day that we commemorate Christ's death, burial, and resurrection. But number two, tomorrow is not promised. And if we want to get very specific, the next moment is not promised. If God were to choose, he could take your life right now. So you have to ask yourself, where am I spiritually? Where is my soul? If I were to die right now, would I lift my eyes up in heaven, or would I lift my eyes up in hell? So I know all the commercialism that's around Easter, but it's not about Easter. It's about his resurrection. Yes. Yes. It's about his resurrection. The songwriter said that he would not come down from the cross to save himself. But he decided to die. He decided to die for people like you and I. He decided to die for people who had messed up. And he knew that they were going to mess up. But he knew that we needed a redeemer so our sins can be forgiven. So I don't know who I'm addressing right now. But all I know that if it was me, that my life need to be realigned up with the Word of God and the Spirit of God, I would take this opportunity and I would just go ahead and step out in the aisle right now and say, listen, I can't live like this no more. I don't want to take a chance on going to hell. And I recognize that he was wounded for all my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. But guess what? With his stripes, I'm healed.
Hallelujah.
I'm healed.